Very good morning, my dear students.
I'm very happy to discuss with you the last unit of advanced financial accounting, that is consignment accounts. My dears, this is the separate and very interesting chapter, that is consignment accounts. Of course, it is similar to joint venture, like joint venture nature. Because we are solving under this chapter the journal entries and ledger accounts relating to the consignment accounts, my dears. So we are going to theory concept first, my dears. Theory concept, that is first one, consignment accounts. Consignment accounts, my dear students. Theory concepts. Theory concepts. Under that theory concepts, we have first the meaning of consignment, my dear students. Meaning of consignment. So here, my dears, meaning, what is meant by consignment? Under that, consignment is an agreement under which a manufacturer or wholesaler sends goods to his agent for the purpose of sale on behalf of or his own risk, my dears. So consignment is just an agreement between two parties, my dears, between two parties. One is the manufacturer or wholesaler. Simply we are treated as the principal. PRINCIPAL, my dears. Principal and agent. It is a contract between principal and agent. Principal sends the goods to his agent for sending the goods and services on behalf of him. Such a agreement we are treated as consignment accounts, my dears. Such a agreement we are treated as consignment agreement. My dear students, we have one more meaning here. The principal sends to an agent to be sold his behalf and his only risk or return for certain percentage of commission. The principal sends the goods to his agent for selling the goods and services on his own risk or on behalf of the consignor or the principal. For the purpose of what is the reward reward to the consignee means, that is commission, my dears. That is commission. He is selling goods and services for the purpose of commission only. The agent will sell the goods and expenses incurred by him and his commission, making sales and remain net sales proceeds to the principal. This type of transaction is called consignment, my dears. So at the time of selling the goods and services by an agent selling the goods and services on behalf of the principal, and he should be deducted his expenditure for sale and commission. The remaining amount should be sending to the principal or the manufacturer or the wholesaler or the consignor, my dears. So one more meaning here, dispatch of goods or sending of goods by a principal to his agent of goods home or abroad for sale on his behalf and his only risk, a return for certain commission called consignment. So it is an agreement between two parties, one party called consignor or principal, second party we are treated as agent, my dears. So consignor or the principal sending the goods to the consignee for the purpose of sale on behalf of consignor, which is own risk or on behalf of consignor, that is called meaning of consignment, my dears. After that, we have definition of consignment accounts. Definition, here there is a definition. Consignment account or consignment may be defined as sending of goods by the principal to his agent to be on behalf of and of own risk in return for certain rate of commission on gross sale proceeds. On gross sale proceeds, that is called definition of consignment, my dears. So consignment may be defined as sending of goods by the principal to his agent to be on behalf of and of own risk in return for a certain rate of commission on the gross sale proceeds. That is called definition about the consignment accounts, my dear students. After that, we have the topic, that is parties of consignment. Parties of consignment. There are two parties. One is consigner. Second one is consignee, my dears. Consigner and consignee. There are two parties. That is consigner and consignee, my dears. So consigner, who is the consigner, means the principal who sends the goods to his agent for sale on behalf of. Such a person we are treated as consigner. Consigner is a maybe wholesaler or maybe the manufacturer who is sending the goods to his agent for sale on behalf of him. On behalf of him, my dears. After that, we have one more meaning. He is a person who sends the goods to consignee on consignment contract for the purpose of sale on behalf of him. For the purpose of sale on behalf of him, that is called consigner, my dear friends. After that, we have consignee. Consignee meaning the agent to whom the goods are sold. The agent to whom the goods are sold. A person who sells the goods and services on behalf of consigner, such a person we are treated as consignee. Consignee is an agent appointed in the business of or in the contract of consignment for selling the goods and services on behalf of consigner. So one more meaning, he is a person who received the goods from consigner on consignment contract for sale to earning certain percentage of commission. He is a person who received the goods from the consigner on consignment contract for sale to earning certain percentage of commission. Such a person we are treated as consignee. My dear students, after that we have very important topic, that is features of consignment, my dears. Features of consignment. What are the special characteristics of consignment, my dear students? What are the special characteristics of consignment? First one is, my dears, features of consignment. It is an agreement between consignor and consignee for sale of particular goods on particular period, my dears. Sale of particular goods on particular period. My dears, once again, it is an agreement between consigner and consignee, my dears. Consigner and consignee for the purpose of sale of particular goods on particular period, my dears. It is an agreement between consigner and consignee for sale of particular goods on particular period. It is the contract between two parties, namely consigner and consignee, for sale of goods and services on particular period. That is the special feature of consignment. The second point is the person who sending the goods on the consignment called consigner. We are already know that the person who sending the goods, such a person we are treated as consigner. The person to whom the goods are sent on consignment called consignee. A person who receive the goods on consignment, such a person we are treated as consignee. Once again, my dear students, consignment, the first feature, it is an agreement between consigner and consignee for sale of particular goods on particular period. Second point is, the person who sending the goods on the consignment, such a person we are treated as consigner. The person who receive the goods on consignment, such a person we are treated as consignee. Next point, my dears. The relationship between consigner and consignee is that of principal and agent, not that buyer and seller. Buyer and seller. So the relationship between the consigner and consignee should be in the nature of principal and agent, but not in the nature of buyer and seller. They are not buyer and sellers. Just agent is a person appointed for selling the goods and services on behalf of consignor for the purpose of earning certain commission, my dears. That's why the relationship between the consignor and consignee like principal and agent. After that, we have fifth one. The goods are sending by the consignor for the purpose of earning profit. My dear students, the goods are sending by the consignor for the purpose of earning profit, my dears. For the purpose of earning profit. The consignor sending the goods to his agent for the purpose of earning profit, my dear students. Earning profit. So the consignor intention is to be only earning the profit, but the goods sold by the consignee for the purpose of earning certain percentage of commission. The principal person, the wholesaler or the manufacturer or the consignor sending the goods to the consignee for the purpose of earning profit, my dears, but the consignee sell the goods on behalf of consignor on consignment for the purpose of earning certain percentage of commission, my dears. Then the consignee sold goods at the risk of consignor is not responsible for any loss, damages or destruction of goods. Very, very important point, my dear students. So what are all the risk faced by the consignee? The whole risk responsible by the consignor only. It is nothing but consignee not responsible for any loss, any damages or any destructions during the consignment process or during the selling of goods and services on consignment. The entire risk borne by consignor only. Consignee not responsible for any risk, any damages, any destructions arisen while consignment agreement. Then next point, my dears. The consignee remits sale proceeds to the consignor of his commission and expenses incurred by him. The consignee remits is nothing but the consignee return the amount of sale proceeds. After the sale, what are the amount returned to the consignor after deducting his percentage of commission and his expenses incurred while selling of goods and services. The net sale proceeds only remitted to the consignor. Then the consignor send account sales to the consignee periodically for after sales on the base of which consignment accounts are prepared. The consignor sends account sales to the consignee periodically for after sale on the base of which consignment accounts are prepared. So we are discussing later what is meant by account sales. Then any stock remaining unsold within the hands of consignor belongs to consignee only. Any stock remaining unsold within the hands of consignee belongs to consignor only. Belongs to consignor only, my dears. Consignor only. Because the entire risk borne by consignor only. Consignee not responsible for any stock, any loss, any damages, any destructions arised in the consignment business. Next one, my dears, any goods are sending by the consignor, we should prepare a pro forma invoice and send to the consignor. Any goods are sending by the consignor, we should prepare a pro forma invoice. My dear students, we are discussing later what is meant by pro forma invoice. Then sometimes the consignor before selling the goods we make the purpose called advance. Sometimes consignee before selling the goods to make the payment. Wait a minute, my dears. To to be make the payment called advance. Sometimes the consignee also pay the some advance amount to the consignor before selling the goods and services. Such amount we are treated as advance, my dears. All the decisions, expenses, losses incurred at the time of consignment are the only responsible for consignor. So consignee is not only not responsible for any decisions, any expenses, any losses, any destructions, isn't it, any damages, because all the responsibilities borne by consignor only. So then my dear students, then the last one is the consignor. Sorry my dears, the consignment of the goods, my dears, the consignment of the goods, consignment of the goods in not sale, it is more transfer of goods or person to another person, whether ownership. Consignment of the goods in not sale, it is more transfer of goods or person to another person, one person to another person. Wait a minute, my dears. Person to another person, whether ownership. There is no ownership in the consignment business, my dears. They are the features of consignment. Features of consignment. After that, we have, my dears, very important topic, that is differences between consignment and sales, my dears. Differences between consignment and sales. So under that, first one is, so what are the consignment? First, we are discussing what are the consignment futures and what are the specially futures of sales, my dears. First one is consignment futures, my dears. After that, we are going to sales futures, my dears. Sales futures. First one is the legal ownership is not transferred from consignor to consignee. The legal ownership is not transferred from consignor to consignee in the consignment. My dears, the opposite form of sale, under sale, opposite markobek aste now. Sale alli opposite markobek, my dears. Yen irutte opposite to, my dears, neeve discuss markobodu. The legal ownership is not transferred from consignor to consignee, but in sales, the legal ownership is transferred, immediately transferred from seller to buyer. That is the difference. The legal ownership is not transferred from consignor to consignee. In the sales, the legal ownership should immediately transfer from buyer to, seller to buyer. Second one, the relationship between consignor and consignee is that principal and agent. The relationship between the consignor and consignee like that principal and agent. In the sales, the relationship between the buyer and seller, purchaser and seller, like buyer and seller, my dear. Buyer and seller. The person who is selling the goods, we are treated as buyer, sorry, seller. The person who purchasing the goods and services, such a person we are treated as buyer, my dears. But the relationship between the persons in the consignment, we are treated as principal and agent. The relationship between the sales, the seller and buyer, we are treated as buyer and seller relationship, my dears. Then the risk of goods with consignor till the goods consigned are sold by the consignee, means at the time of sending the goods to selling the goods, the entire risk borne by consignor only. But in case of sale, the risk of goods with the buyers, with the seller till the goods are sold. Till the goods are sold. After the sale, entire risk borne by buyer only. Buyer only. The risk of goods until the sale borne by seller. After the sale borne by buyer. Next, the expenses incurred by the consignor are borne by the consignor. The entire expenses borne by consignor only. But under sale, the expenses before the sale incurred by seller, after the sale incurred by seller, my dears. Seller. After that, we have, if the goods are not sold by the consignee, may return to the goods to the consignor. Any goods remain unsold, such goods return to the consignor. Such goods return to the consignor. but in case of sale, but in case of sale, once the goods are sold, may not be returned to the seller, may not be returned to the seller by the buyer. Next difference, my dears, account sales must be prepared and submitted periodically. Account sales must be prepared and submitted periodically, but in sales, no need of account sales. Then, actual of goods may or may not be transferred to consignment. Actual of goods may or may not be transferred to consignment, but in case of sale, actual of goods must be transferred to the sales register. Next, goods once sold cannot be returned. Goods once sold cannot be returned, but in case of sales, if any damages, goods should be returned. If any damages, goods should be returned. So they are the differences between sales and consignment, my dears. Sales and consignment. After that, we have advance, my dear students. After that, we have advance. What is meant by advance? The theoretical concept, my dear students. The theoretical concept, that is advance, my dears. Sometimes consignor may ask the consignee to pay an advance for the part of value of goods of the consignee. Sometimes the consignor only asking to the consignee for part payment about the goods and services which are sending by the consignor. Such amount we are treated as advance. So, the consignee may send advance in the form of check or draft, my dears. In the form of check or draft. So, the consignee may be transferring the advance amount in the form of check or in the form of draft, my dears. Then, my dears, pro forma invoice. Already, we know that pro forma invoice, my dears. Pro forma invoice. What is meant by pro forma invoice? Here, my dears, it is a statement prepared and sent by the consignor to the consignee for the details of goods sent. For the details of goods sent. My dears, under consignment business, consignor prepared a statement regarding the detailed information of goods and services which are sending by the consignor to the consignee. Such a statement we are treated as pro forma invoice. Pro forma invoice. It is a statement include the detailed information relating to the goods which are sending by the consignor to the consignee on consignment. On consignment, that is called pro forma invoice. That is called pro forma invoice, my dear students. After that, we have account sales, my dears. That is account sales. So, what is meant by account sales, my dears? It is a statement prepared and sent by consignee to the consignor, either completion of sale of goods or periodical intervals. My dears, so a statement prepared by the consignor, that is called pro forma invoice. A statement prepared by the consignee, that is called account sales. It gives the particulars such as gross sales, expenses, losses, advance, etc. My dear, simple here. Simple logical point is the detailed information of goods sent by the consignor recorded in the statement. Such a statement we have treated as pro forma invoice. The details of selling the goods and services, commission, sales, expenses, losses, advances recorded and prepared a statement by consignee, such a statement we are treated as account sales, my dears. That is called account sales. After that, we have normal loss, my dears. Normal loss. Normal loss is there which are called by normal ways or available causes like loading, unloading, and breaking, my dears. Simple meaning, normal losses are the losses arising by normal ways, at the time of loading the goods and services, at the time of unloading the goods and services, at the time of breakings. So normal losses are the losses which are arised in the normal ways. Then very important aspect, my dears, that is commission. That is called commission, my dears, commission. What is meant by commission? It is the remuneration payable to the consignee for services rendered to the consignor in the form of selling of goods and services on consignment. Commission is the payment payable by the consignor to the consignee for rendering services by the consignee in the form of selling of goods and services on behalf of consignor. On behalf of consignor, my dears. So it is the remuneration, it is the payment payable by the consignor to the consignee for rendering services on behalf of consignor on consignment contract. That is called commission. We are different categories of commission under consignment business. That is three categories. That is normal commission or ordinary commission. Second one is Del Crider commission. Third one is overriding commission. Normal commission is nothing but same meaning. It is the payment given by the consignor to the consignee for goods sold on consignment contract. It is generally fixed of a certain percentage of total sales. Certain percentage on total sales, my dears. On total sales. So it is the payment given by the purchaser or given by the consignor to the consignee. To the consignee, isn't it, for selling the goods and services on consignment. Generally, it's fixed on sales only. On sales only. That is called ordinary commission, my dear. That is called ordinary commission. After that, Del Crider commission, my dears. After that, Del Crider commission. Very important, my dears, for the point of examination. For the point of examination, it's an important Del Crider commission. It is the extra commission payable by the consignor to the consignee for his special services called Del Crider commission. Called Del Crider commission, my dears. Del Crider commission. It is the special commission payable by the consignor to the consignee for the purpose of special services rendered by the consignee. Means it is an additional commission, my dears. It is an additional commission paid to the consignor to bear the loss of bad debts incurred by him. Bad debts incurred by him. It is calculated on the total sales or credit sales. The consignee gets extra commission for his special services when incurred bad debt. My dears, simple. Del Crider commission, it is the special commission payable by the consignor to the consignee for recovery of bad debts or when he incurred the bad debts. Of course, bad debts are common in the business. When the consignee recovered the bad debts, at that time he is eligible for special commission. Such a commission we are treated as Del Crider commission. After that, we have overriding commission, the last concept of commission. My dears, once again, we have three categories of commission, my dears. One is ordinary commission, second one is Del Crider commission, third one is overriding commission. What is meant by overriding commission? It is the extra commission payable by the consignor to the consignee to promote sales at higher price than the actual price and to increase the consignee's efforts and hard works when introducing new line of product in the market. My dears, means overriding commission also is an extra commission, my dears. It is also an extra commission payable by the consignor to the consignee when he is selling the goods and services higher than the normal price, higher than the actual price. For example, the consigners instructed to consignee for selling the goods and services for 50 per kg, but consignee selling the goods and services 70 per kg at the time is eligible for overriding commission. Or second case is when a new line of product introducing in the market, at the time also they are is eligible for overriding commission. It is the commission paid on over and above the ordinary commission. Over and above the ordinary commission, my dears. So that is your consignment chapter theory concept, my dear students. Theory concept. Thank you. Thank you very much.